seconds here. It's a luxury comedy. We're in a coffee shop this time. I know what you're thinking. That sounds like the setting for a boring sitcom. It's not going to be boring, because I've put a little twist on it. It's a coffee shop on the edge of a volcano in Hawaii. Oh, it's going to be great. I mean, I've never had a job before. No one's going to give me a job in real life, are they?
No, who are you talking to?
The people watching at home. Just giving them a way in, you know, a friendly map and compass. Because apparently last time, a couple of people were confused.
Okay, so introduce me then.
All right, I'm just getting round to it. This is Dolly, my cool friend. We used to go out back in the day, but I had to end it.
Yeah, Noel, I ended it.
I ended it?
Noel, I ended it.
No, if you remember,
Noel, if you remember, I ended it because you kept asking me to do that thing, you know, with the...
Yeah, all right, can we not talk about that on telly?
Sure.
This is Smooth, my second in command. Check him out. I won him in a card game. He's an anteater. Imagine that. You are an anteater, aren't you?
Yeah, why?
No, it's just that you look like you're in Star Wars.
I'm mixed race.
Mixed race?
Yeah, my mum's an anteater, my dad's a man.
Well, your dad got off of an anteater? It's a bit weird, isn't it?
Yeah, it is a bit weird, but can you pipe down? My parents are sitting over there.
Oh, where's Andy Warhol?
He's in the cupboard.
Still, he's been in there since the first series.
I know, he's decked it all out to look like Studio 54.
Get him out, quick, the show started.
What is this? Where am I? What's happening?
It's okay, calm down. You're in the second series.
We got another series?
Yeah. We're in a coffee shop this time.
Sounds like the setting for a boring sitcom to me.
I've already been over this. It's not going to be. I'll put a twist on it. It's basically a coffee shop on the edge of a volcano in Hawaii. Check it out.
I'm not sure that putting a coffee shop on the edge of a volcano is such a good idea.
Why not?
I foresee trouble.
Oh, Andy, stop being such a square. You know, it's cool that we're all in Hawaii. You're just freaking out because you don't wear shorts.
I hate shorts.
I know you do. No one's going to make you wear shorts, Andy. It's fine. Smooth, how are you feeling about the whole Hawaiian vibe?
It's a bit of a weird location for a new business. I mean, you're new to the service industry as it is.
Who are you? Deborah Meaden?
No, I'm not, but can you keep it down? She's sitting over there with Peanut Jones.
I think it's Peter Jones. I know, you're right, that is Peanut Jones. Okay, yeah, let's talk about who's doing what. Smooth, you'll be making the coffee.
I'm the fastest in the business.
How fast are you exactly?
Smooth!
That is pretty fast. Andy, I see you as front of house.
Why?
It's just that you're going to really get on well with the general public.
Oh, actually, sorry, can I have a bit less froth than that, please?
Okay.
And what about you?
Well, you know, I'm the captain of the ship, the face of luxury coffee. In fact, I've done an ad campaign. It's pretty exciting. There's billboards all around the island. Check this out.
Sitting in Hawaii, drinking up a coffee, sip on the froth and suck my beans.
Okay, any weird stuff off the internet that we can get involved in?
Yeah, there's the new Paul Panfer film.
Love Paul Panfer.
Oh, me too.
Yes, he's an internet sensation.
I tell you, Paul Panfer's gone from strength to strength since he started remaking Elvis films on his mobile phone.
Yeah, he's remade Blue Hawaii. Look, it's already got 9 million hits.
Paul Panfer in Blue Hawaii! Starring Tony Curtis and Curtis Tony! Yeah!
Wow, I never seen waves so dramatic.
Oh no, you would have to be a madman to go surfing today.
Those waves must be 50 foot tall.
100 foot tall at least.
Have you caught the girls?
No.
Why not?
Because I don't know them, and neither you. Don't mention it again.
Oh my God.
Look!
It can't be. I see someone out there. It's Paul Panfer.
Whoa!
Look at him go, man.
He's so reckless.
It's like he just doesn't care.
He doesn't care.
He's maverick. You know why he doesn't care?
Why?
Because he's Paul Panfer.
For Paul Panfer right now.
Paul Panfer is my new muse.
I've invented a special Paul Panfer coffee.
Have you?
It's more than a coffee, it's an experience, really.
It's amazing.
Wow.
Froth smells like the ocean. Got a tiny sugar sculpture of Paul. And if you want extra milk, you squeeze it out of his blue tit.
Andy, put it on the specials board.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Sitting in Hawaii, drinking up a coffee, sip on the froth and sun beans.
What are you doing?
It's writing a letter to Paul Panfer.
Let me see.
No, it's personal.
Get up, what are you doing?
I'm just going to have a little look.
Don't just read a letter from one man to his hero.
Dear Paul Panfer, loved your latest film, Blue Hawaii. I myself run a coffee shop in Hawaii. So if you fancy popping in, you can have free coffee. In fact, I've invented a coffee in your honor.
Sorry about that.
I think we might be kindred spirits and could easily be best friends. Love you a little bit, Noel. P.S. I'm writing this in the nude.
Yeah, all right.
That is possibly the most embarrassing letter I've ever seen.
Well, no one asked you to read it. Why don't you just keep your big German nose out?
What is wrong with you? Why are you so uncool? I mean, besides, he's not going to respond to this, Noel.
Well, he might do. He might come round.
No, that's the whole point of Paul Panfer. He doesn't care about this stuff, you know? And anyway, he can't even read.
Well, he must have people around him who can read.
I doubt it.
Anyway, look, it's up to me. If I want to write a letter to Paul Panfer, I will. And I think he might read this, be touched by my words, and I think he might pop round.
Do you?
Right, this is urgent. Post that to Paul Panther's house. Hello?
All right, no.
All right, Peter.
Who is it?
Secret Peter, my landlord.
Listen, there's a bit of a problem with the coffee shop.
What do you mean?
Well, like, you can't just put a coffee shop in Hawaii on the edge of a volcano.
Why not?
Well, because, like, it's sacred land, innit? Like, you upset the locals.
What locals?
The customer, Magnum P.I. They're outside the shop now. Why don't you have a look? If you've got binoculars at hand.
Easy, Magnum. My God, they look furious.
They are furious. Because you offended them. And you've offended their volcano.
Right. So what am I going to do?
You're going to do the right thing, though. You're going to have to sacrifice someone to the volcano to make it right again.
Yeah, what if I don't?
Well, if you don't, they said they're gonna sacrifice you.
Blimey.
Yeah, they're gonna lose you in the hole like a chicken wishbone.
Hey, Noel, you can't just put a coffee shop on a volcano.
I've already told him that, ain't I?
What do you think the purpose of this
phone call is? I think we're just talking about flowers. Why don't you go and do something useful like the pot noodles?
I'm doing them. I just put the water in and I'm letting them stand.
Don't make mine too watery again. If I wanted soup, I'd go get soup. You hear me? with that?
That's Danny DeVito.
Where's she going?
Magaluf.
Yeah, as much as I'm enjoying the pot noodle monologues, I should probably go and deal with the locals.
Pot Panfer in
Dahaswa! It's a film!
Not big enough to swing a cat in here. What's wrong with you? Go to sleep! I can't go to sleep. It's a midnight tonight. Pot Panther's breaking out. Pot Panther's not breaking out. He is too. He's gonna break out. He's gonna concentrate on his musical career. He has a good voice. He says he's gonna get out. Wait till things settle down. And then maybe in like 5 years, come back for me. He's not coming back for you. He doesn't even know you, huh? You just saw him once in the rec room playing table tennis. You said hello to him, he just walked away. You say that, but as he walked away, I heard him say really quietly, I'm coming back for you in 5 years. At the time, I didn't know what he was talking about, but it all makes sense now. Pot Panther's not getting out of here. No one's getting out of here. What's that noise? That's the sound the alarm makes when someone's getting out of here. Look, it's Pot Panther. He's surfing his way to freedom on the back of a laundry trunk. Don't forget to concentrate on your music, Pot Panther. The fuck? We can get out of here. This stuff's made of nothing. Come on, let's go.
Let's get the fuck out of here. Paul, wait for us.
Wait
for us, Paul.
We're coming for you.
Oh, fucking hell.
Incredible.
That is his best film.
What's wrong with you? Have you gone off Paul Panther?
No, of course I haven't gone off Paul Panther. Just got a lot on my mind, haven't I?
Oh, the volcano sacrifice.
Time's running out, old chap.
Well, just make a decision, why don't you?
It's not that simple, is it?
Just get rid of Roy Circles.
I am Roy Circles. I'm the king of my own packet.
Can't get rid of Roy Circles, can I? He's a school teacher. What about the children's futures?
Noel, he's not a school teacher. He's a chocolate biscuit who thinks he's a school teacher.
I suppose I could sacrifice him. Just dunk him in the volcano like it was a big cup of tea.
Yeah, just snap him up and chuck him in.
What?
Just snap him up and chuck him in.
No, there's nothing more I'd like to do than sacrifice myself to a volcano. I dream of being reunited with my wife. Unfortunately, though, it is sports day tomorrow. The most important day for a PE teacher. And even if I say it myself, we are red hot favourites this year. We have got, from the African Exchange Programme, Stephen Cahilly in the 10,000 metres. If he didn't win, I'll eat my own whistle. And our secret weapon all the way from South London, Ian Hartfield. Although only 7 years old and 18 stone, he can shift a javelin like it was an HB pencil. Who saw that coming with the chubby tooting maestro?
Oh, Roy, I could never sacrifice you.
No, you couldn't. If you want my advice, I'll probably do Tony Reason.
Why?
Well, he's a fish, isn't he? Fuck him.
Oh, all right, Tony.
Before you even open your mouth, can I just say, I was the first character you invented for this show.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, and because of that, you've got a soft spot for me, a bit like a firstborn child.
That's true.
Plus, how many other shows do you know that have got a talking manta ray as a music producer in them?
I know, all right. I can't sacrifice you. I'm aware of that.
Plus, I'm the only character in the show with any sort of cultural integrity, which moves me on swiftly to my next point, Paul Panther.
What about Paul Panther?
Awful. Never seen so much bilge, going around ruining the reputation of Elvis Presley.
I love Paul Panther.
Shoddy remakes. Elvis must be spinning in his grave, quite literally.
Well, the thing is, Tone, the kids dig Paul Panfer, you know? He's an internet sensation. Can't fight progress.
Well, if that's what the kids are digging, I don't want any part of it.
Come on, that's not true. Everyone knows you're down with the kids. You work with Rizzle Kicks, don't you?
Rizzle Kicks live in the same street as me. So occasionally, I pay them some extra pocket money to clean my car. It's not really the same thing, is it?
No, I suppose. What am I going to do? I've got to sacrifice someone.
Well, if you want my opinion, I'd sacrifice New York cop.
Really? Why?
Well, he's American, isn't he? Not the same as us, are they?
Bit racist. Look, the thing is, Raymond, you know, the locals have really forced my hand, and someone's going to have to be sacrificed to the volcano. And unfortunately, that someone is you.
Let me tell you something about Hawaii. It has the highest crime rate in the world. Are you aware of that?
Really?
Oh, yeah. Very bad place. Very bad place. You take me out of the equation. Who's going to police the area? I predict very bad things. Very bad things indeed.
What kind of things?
Parking offences. Fraud. Robbery. The other day, the mayor was kidnapped in broad daylight, taken back to some guy's shed, and forced to drink Tizer at knife point. Free cans. Free cans, I tell you. The guy was full and gassy, too.
Well, I had no idea that Hawaii was so dangerous.
Oh, yeah. And with me out of the equation, there'll be no one left to solve these crimes.
What about Magnum, you fat son of a bitch?
Jesus, I forgot about Magnum.
Okay, take Hooper. He's hopeless anyway.
Well, I can't believe you'd throw me down the river like that.
Where is Hooper?
Hooper likes to ride in the trunk. He feels better in there.
Okay. The thing is, it's Magnum that's the problem, you know? He's one of the locals. He's the main local.
You know, I went to rookie college with him.
Hooper! Went to rookie college with Magnum, didn't I? Don't answer that!
I went to rookie college with that guy. Before he turned his back on the force and became a PI, I hated him.
You were jealous of him! Because he looked like him, only a fatter version!
You shut up!
Plus, he dated Mrs. Boombox before you did. Everyone knows that.
Okay, look, let's get one thing clear. They went on one date together, in the daytime, to the Boat Propeller Museum, okay? And they only held hands for, like, 2 seconds maximum. Mrs. Boombox assures me of those facts. In fact, she offered to take a lie detector test.
I'm sure she did. All right, look, I'll do a deal with you. You take care of Magnum and the locals, yeah? And I won't sacrifice you or Trunk Boy.
Okay, I'll take the case.
Great. But can you hurry up? Because there's like 7 minutes until the end of the episode.
I'm just waiting for you to leave and then I will snap into action.
Bye.
Hooper, is he gone?
Fuck you, fat man.
Okay. Let's watch Paul Panfer films. I love this guy. He is an internet sensation.
What's wrong with you? I couldn't do it. I couldn't sacrifice Tony Reason on New York Cop. I mean, I love those guys.
No, I think I know why you couldn't do it.
Why?
It is because you play those characters. But it'd be like killing a part of yourself.
Never looked at it like that. I can't sacrifice a character I play. Who does that leave? Oh, you three.
Well done, Andy.
You tit.
No, don't blame me. No, I'm not the one that put the coffee shop on the volcano. I warned him. There's only one tit here, and it's that tit there. The tit with the hair.
Yeah, okay. Look, the thing is, somebody's got to be sacrificed, okay? I'm going to interview you for you and make a decision. I mean, come on, it could be fun. Like the Hawaiian Apprentice.
Yeah, no one dies in The Apprentice, Noel.
Okay, smooth. Why shouldn't I sacrifice you?
Well, firstly, I do all the work in the coffee shop. Plus, we're brothers in real life, so if you did sacrifice me, Mum would kill you.
That is true. Andy?
On Friday, I'm having a sleepover. You could come. Picasso will be there with Miro and Salvador Dali.
Really?
Yes, the Spanish boys.
Right, and what sort of things will we be getting up to?
We'll be eating tapas.
I love tapas. Right, Dolly, why shouldn't I sacrifice you?
Please don't sacrifice me, Noel. Please, please do not sacrifice me. Please.
Can you stop begging? It's so uncool.
No, that's where you're wrong. Begging's come back in.
I didn't know that.
Exactly. There's lots of things you don't know. I tell you what's cool and what's not cool. You need me.
Okay, so cool, tapas, mum's gonna kill me. Oh, no, I can't do it. You're my three best friends in the world. I mean, I can't sacrifice one of you lot.
What are we gonna do?
I don't know. Let's just get out of here.
Hold it right there. Time's up, I'm afraid, old boy. Okay, you had until the end of the episode to sacrifice someone to the volcano. You failed. So now you and the rest of your staff will all be sacrificed.
This is like the Scum Manifesto all over again.
Looks a bit warm in there.
I can't believe this is how I'm gonna die. Sacrificed to a volcano. It's so uncool.
Look, it's poor Panfer. Must have got my letter.
Paul, over here!
Who are you? What's happening?
Oh my god, Paul Panther has fallen into the volcano!
What a dick.
Freeze!
You're too late, Paul Panther's already saved us.
Where's Magnum?
I think his head is over there.
Mind if I keep this?
What for?
We're at home, surprise Mrs. Boombox.
It's a bit perverse, isn't it?
Listen to me, Noel. We've been married for 25 years, you do what you gotta do to keep things spicy in the bedroom. I'm talking Boona times.
Fair enough.
Well, look, what is happening?
There's Paul Panther.
Paul Panther, you single-handedly kept my legacy alive. You ever reimagined all my films for a new generation? I love you, Paul Panther. Surf into my arms.
Come to mama, Paul Panther. Come to mama.
Panther!
Panther!